Since I started my channel a few months ago, I've been trying to find the right tool to help me plan and script my YouTube videos and help me organize my ideas, and I think I finally found it. In this video, I want to show you how I use Milanote for my YouTube workflow. Hi, my name is Dan. I call myself the lazy creator because too often my full-time job and life gets in the way of creating. I want to help other creators find the right tools to simplify their workflows and motivate them to create more. If you're interested in that, consider subscribing, but let's jump into the video. Up until recently, I found the planning process really, really painful, and I mostly used Evernote to script my videos. Now, if you don't know what Evernote is, it's a note-taking app that's been around for, I'd say, about 10 years. I was never really a big fan of it, even though the last update made it so much better. Anyway, I came across a video by YouTubers Becky and Chris where they talk about another note-taking app called Milanote that they are using for their videos. I'll link that video below in case you want to check it out. Now, as soon as I started testing it myself, I was impressed as to how easy it was to organize my ideas and thoughts in Milanote, and it's now become my primary tool to plan out my own videos. It's a super easy drag and drop interface and very intuitive, so you can focus on your creative work instead of formatting your notes. So let's jump into Milanote and I'll show you how I'm using it. Okay, so here we are in Milanote. I am using the free version at the moment that allows you to have up to 100 notes and elements. After that, you will need to upgrade. The pro version is $9.99 per month if billed annually, or $12.50 on the monthly plan, USD that is. The basic interface is organized by columns and boards, so all of this is one board, and then I have a few other boards here organized within columns. This is one column, this is another one. And on the left hand side, you then have all the different tools that are available to you. You have notes, links, to-do lists, lines, boards, columns, and comments if you're working with a team. And you can also add files such as images or PDF files. I'm not going to go into detail here now because we see these tools in action once we jump into my YouTube boards. But the general idea is that you can just grab one of those tools and then just drag it onto your board, and then you can, you know, start typing and move it around where you want it. Now, the tools, as you see, are quite limited, but personally, I really like this because there are not endless options for fonts and sizes and colors, which helps focusing on what's important. Because let me tell you, I can spend an hour formatting my notes instead of working on the actual project. All right, so let's jump into my YouTube board. And you see I have a number of different columns to organize all the ideas and videos I'm working on. It starts with a column for video ideas where I have different to-do lists based on different content categories. And it's super simple to, you know, I can add another content category. I want to start a new video or idea. And I can easily add a title here, category, and start a new list. It's super, super simple. And then I'll have different columns for the videos as they're moving through the different stages of production. So I have a pre-production column, a in-production, completed, and published. Pre-production, obviously, it's when I work on the script. In production is when I'm filming it and editing it, and then completed if it's finished but not posted yet. And then once I published it, then it ends up in this column. And it's super easy to just, you know, click one of those videos and drag it to another column as the status changes. Super simple and easy to reorganize whenever you want to. All right, next up is my video board. Let's look at the last video that I uploaded, and I'll link it up here in case you want to check out the end result. Okay, so once again, you see it's a very clean interface, a very easy and simple overview of all the tasks relating to this video. It starts here with a project management column where I add all my to-dos for this project. And I have another note down here for title ideas. The next column is for inspiration, where I collect all the resources for this video and links. That could be a video or an article you read that inspired this video. Down here I have another board for the script. Now this might look a little disorganized to you. I'm still refining this section, but in this I have different notes with different headlines for each different element of the video, and also some notes in between for the B-roll transitions from one part to another. And you see I have these connected here with arrows, which move around as I move these notes around as well. So that's very simple. Let's go back here. I also have a shot list where I plan all the different clips and all the different scenes I need for this video, and a thumbnail column where I collect a few ideas. Now in this case I knew exactly what I wanted, so I don't have a number of ideas, and then the final thumbnail that I used. Now if you want to add another column, it's super simple. You can just grab a column here, add it here, and for example you want to add some SEO tags that you want to add to your video. Let's do that. So, and then you just add another note in here, and let's do this as a bullet point list. So tag 1, tag 2, tag 3. You can move it around however you want and build your template. I also just wanted to quickly show you how you can create a new video and use a template for your new video. So you just grab a new board here, add it to pre-production, say new video. Now you can change the icon, so you can choose a different icon. You have different options. You can also change the color. And then once you go into a new empty board, it gives you this little window here where you can choose a template. Now these are Milanote templates, but if you go to more templates, you can see your custom templates in here. So I have a YouTube video template that I'm using. So I just click this here and use this template. So, and then you have all the elements you usually use, so you can start working right away on your video instead of having to build the board from scratch.
That's it for this run through. I've linked my template that I use for my videos in the description below in case you want to grab that. It's a PDF file because currently Milanote doesn't offer an export and import function for templates, but it shouldn't take long for you to build your own based on that template. In this example, I showed you the desktop app, but you can also use the web version or the phone app. It's obviously all linked and your notes are synced across all devices. What I like about the phone app in particular is that you have quick notes where you can quickly dump some text in case you're in a hurry without having to go into any particular video or create a new board, which I always found a bit difficult with Evernote. One major letdown for me though is that Milanote currently don't have an iPad app, and I'm hoping they are working on that right now because I want to use a scribble, you know, scribbling away with the Apple Pencil, getting all the notes in, because that's how it's done in 2020, right? Anyway, again, grab my template if you like to use it, if you want to check that out, and yeah. That's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please give it a like so YouTube can suggest it to more people. It really makes a difference. Also let me know in the comments below if you are using Milanote or what other note-taking app you're using for your projects or videos. I'm really keen to know. And yeah, subscribe if you want to stay in touch, and thank you so much for watching. Take care.